BRB Blazer.
Yeah. Drake. They already knew what they want. Yeah, Drake. Yeah.
Let's just stay on Drake real fast because I know we didn't really touch too much on him. I think you brought him up on the thing. Well, how do you guys feel about Kenny and Drake going into next year with this situation? Has he been officially re-signed yet, or are there discussions?
Well, they got the
tag,
transition tag.
The transition tag. So he's got like the draft pick tender on him. Wherever if someone wants to sign him, they can match it. And then if they lose him, then they get a compensatory draft
pick. Which rarely happens, I feel like.
Drake.
Yeah. I mean, me personally, I'm a homer pick. So, and like, we've seen how explosive Drake can be when he's given the opportunity. And it is just frustrating, you know, like in the beginning of last year, like they just wouldn't give him the ball. They give him the ball like 10 times, 12 times a game, if that. But then he goes over to Arizona and, you know, he's getting the ball 15 plus, 20 plus times a game. And you kind of just see him explode, even against some of these like pretty good defenses that they faced against. He still had, you know, a good showing. So, I mean, I love Drake next year. Posted something to the fantasy counselor that you know, I would beer bet him that Kenyon Drake finishes better than David Johnson.
Drake. I know me and him had a beer bet a couple years, or not a beer bet, but a bet for Kenyon Drake. But I mean, he's he fits the system for sure.
Yeah.
I mean, he can catch, he can run good routes, he lines up. Even when they run like five wide, he's the other guy. And he can catch. I mean, and they like him there. So I think if he stays healthy, he's going to be, at worst, like a mid running back too. But, yeah, I mean, the upside could be a running back one.
Yeah.
Even though I really don't even like him that much. But he looked good, though. I mean,
I was doing some of my early rankings. It's early. You still got all these rookies coming in. You still got a couple free agents getting signed and whatnot. But I wanted to throw Drake into my top 10 at, like, my, like, 10, 11, 12 area kind of over there. And I think it's not out of the realm of possibility. You know, if he can get 50, 60 receptions, and he can get, you know, 200, you know, 30, 250 rushes, you know, with that offense, you know, being explosive as it is, you know, you have these playmakers on the outside. Kyler Murray can run the ball. I know you've touched on Anthony where, you know, when you have those RPO running quarterbacks, it kind of really opens up the lanes for these running backs. And, you know, like I said, Drake's explosive. I mean, we've seen plenty of plays where, you know, you think he's going to get tackled and he hits a spin move out of the backfield and boom, he busts like a 60-yard run down the sideline. So, yeah, I like Drake next year going forward. He's going to be one of my favorite guys. We just got to pay a little bit more attention kind of how things unfold through the draft and whatnot.
Yeah, he was like I think he was over 5 yards of carry in Arizona.
Yeah.
He was, the line was, it's not much better, but it's better than Miami. So, like you said, that RPO, Kyler Murray having to worry about that. It's definitely going to lead to some explosive plays where you just weren't seeing those explosive plays out of David Johnson.
Yeah.
It wouldn't surprise me either if he falls in my top 12 when we get closer to the season. Especially if you don't really go out and draft anybody and then stick with Edmonds and him. And, you know, if he's the full-time starter, we've seen when he gets the workload, he does put consistent. It's been consistent points with him when he gets a workload, too.
For sure,
it's not even like it's just one good game here, one good game there. When he gets that workhorse workload, he puts up solid numbers. So that's something to, like, you know, getting closer to the year, we'll see what they do with the offseason, maybe if they sign another running back or a draft, if they draft someone. But, I mean, if he's going to be the workhorse, he's – you know, I'll probably pace out some numbers and do some statistics with that. But, I mean, it wouldn't surprise me if I have him in my top 12, like, going into season, if nothing changes.
For sure. Just kind of like real quick before we move on to the next thing, Drake or David Johnson?
Drake.
And because they're probably going to draft an O-lineman with 9. They're probably going to get better. So they'll take an O-lineman that's going to probably play immediately because they really didn't.
Yeah, and they protect Kyler, too.
Yeah, and he came into the season halfway through. So, I mean, not saying he didn't know the plays, but he has a whole offseason now of learning the playbook. So, I mean, he's just more invested into the whole system. So I think
it's
to get worse.
Might only even help his passing upside because now he knows the protections and all that stuff. So.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I would take him. And if David Johnson does better and you draft him, well, you know what? Good for you.
Yeah, for sure. All right.
BRB Blazer.